Tell me how I'm supposed to breathe with no air. Every air-cooled owner ever.
What is coolant and how long should it last?
Cricket.
Oh, you want the answer? All right.
Your typical engine coolant is gonna be a mixture of water and antifreeze.
Basically, engine coolant is...
I'm gonna give a terrible answer for this one.
You are.
Comprised of ethylene and propylene glycol.
Coolant is a product that makes your car cool.
You transfer heat from your engine, throws it to your radiator. That's where everything cools down by air and sends it back over.
Antifreeze is what the name suggests it is.
First step is that you actually have to know how to be cool.
It prevents the coolant inside the engine from freezing at extreme temperatures.
Coolant is formulated so that it does not corrode.
Story's a little bit more than that.
And you have to be driving a car that people think is cool.
The antifreeze actually has quite a bit of additives in it.
If you're not, then your coolant doesn't exist.
How long it's supposed to last? Again, that's like a manufacturer thing.
4 years, 50,000 miles, 8 years, 100,000 miles, really go by whatever the manufacturer says.
Every manufacturer is going to have like a general time frame when to change it.
Most manufacturers will say coolant can last between 7 and 15 years.
My car, I'm probably not letting it go more than 3 years.
How do you know which coolant to run?
You can do whatever you want, but I wouldn't.
I would just stick to whatever the manufacturer wants you to put in your car.
Check the manual.
Don't play engineer.
Hit the Google.
Manufacturers specifically formulate these coolants.
It's a system that they've spent countless hours designing.
For the particular engines that they're running in.
Hit FCP Euro.
You could do, you know, waterless.
They work with fluid manufacturers to design the correct fluid for the system they've engineered.
You could do some water wetter additives.
Do what they recommend.
Please, always use the correct antifreeze for your application.
We just recommend to consider manufacturer.
Silicone versus OEM rubber hoses, which is better?
Boy.
Oof.
I'm an OEM guy.
I have no opinion.
Open-ended question. Again, I'm not gonna pick size on this one.
Silicone, baby.
I personally like OEM hoses.
Oh, silicone definitely will last longer than rubber hoses.
They're reinforced these days. It's not like the old days where they're really thin.
Outside of a daily driving kind of feel, OEM rubber is perfectly fine with me.
Silicone, obviously.
That's all I got.
Just maintain your cars.
So what happens if you're going down the road and you look down and all of a sudden your temperature gauge is in the red, your car's overheating?
If you're on the side of the road in the middle of nowhere in upstate New York after a deer just hit you.
I experienced that last night.
Reminiscing?
Yeah, a little bit, yeah.
Pull over immediately, your car's starting to overheat and you can cause some serious engine damage.
Pray and hope that you didn't do any further damage to your car.
My strategy is start swearing.
A number of different things could go wrong when that happens.
I've seen a lot of cars that are on fire, so.
Get really, really upset.
I need a cell phone so I can call 911.
Then start to use your brain.
Get it towed and find out what actually happened and what further damage, because it's never just, oh, my car overheated.
I would look into either your water pump leaking.
Find the coolant leak, which there will be.
Thermostat, anything coolant related leaking.
There's levels to this.
There's levels of damage.
Car's electronic now. You don't even use gas or oil. You just plug it in, bro.
How come track cars just run straight water and street cars can run something else?
Because race cars are generally not driven during the winter.
Track car typically breaks down a lot faster.
If we're talking about in the cooling system, coolant is just an additive.
Coolant could be anything. It could be water. I mean, they even have like waterless coolant now, which is kind of cool.
Water is going to cool just as good as like antifreeze or engine coolant, if not better.
Also, coolant, when it spills on a track, it's not safe.
If you were to, let's say, get in an accident or the radiator was damaged and you started leaking.
And most people that are driving a track car, their car's not going to run long, so they're not really worried about the coolant.
Coolant, it's slippery, and you really have to clean that up.
Antifreeze onto the racetrack, you're going to make life pretty miserable for everybody else.
You don't want the next guy coming behind you, you know, breaking on your coolant and sliding off the track.
Remember, if you ain't first, you're last.
That's a great answer. I can't argue with that. It's really good.
What's up, YouTube? Do you have questions about your car that you're a little embarrassed to ask? Leave them in the comments below, and we'll address them in a future episode.
You know YouTube doesn't watch your videos, right?
I'm just doing what I'm told to do. I'm a Muppet here.